Mexico's president visited Washington today, meeting with President Obama at the White House. Though he campaigned and had an early record as a reformer, corruption scandals and public outcry have sparked a political crisis for the Mexican leader. One recent newspaper poll showed that he has the lowest approval for a head of state there in nearly 20 years.
Our first meeting of the year is with one of our closest allies, neighbors, and friends.
And that's no accident, of course. Mexican President Enrique Peña Nieto arrived at a moment when Mr. Obama most needs his help on two major initiatives. First, his November order to defer deportations for millions of undocumented immigrants.
I described to President Peña Nieto our efforts to fix our broken immigration system here in the United States and to strengthen our borders as well. We are going to provide a mechanism so that families are not separated who've been here for a long time, but that we're also going to be much more aggressive at the border in ensuring that people come through the system legally.
And second, the move toward normalizing relations with Cuba. American isolation of the Castro regime has long been an irritant in broader U.S. Latin American relations.
I've acknowledged the very audacious decision that you've made to reestablish diplomatic relations with Cuba, and Mexico will be a tireless supporter of the good relationship between two neighbors.
The Mexican leader may also hope today's visit to snowy Washington grants him respite from an avalanche of crises at home. He took office in December 2012, but just 2 years later, he is reeling. Last June, 22 gang members were killed by Mexican soldiers outside Mexico City. Mounting evidence now suggests it was a massacre. Then in September, the kidnapping and presumed murders of 43 college students in Guerrero State, allegedly by a drug cartel working with a corrupt mayor and police.
I want something done, concrete actions and not just words.
Massive protests over the crime and the government's apparently casual response have filled streets throughout Mexico. And now it is alleged that private contractors bankrolled lavish homes for the president and his wife, as well as Finance Minister Luis Videgaray, who met with Vice President Biden this morning. But Peña Nieto has also pushed reforms, taking on the powerful teachers union and seeking to change Mexico's outmoded state-run oil company, Pemex, and implement reforms in the country's telecommunications sector. The president can also point to notable arrests last year in Mexico's long-running drug war, including perhaps the most wanted man on earth, Joaquin El Chapo Guzman, head of the Sinaloa cartel. For more on the Mexican president's leadership and challenges, I'm joined by Carlos Bravo Regidor. He's a political analyst at the Center for Research and Teaching in Economics. It's a Mexican think tank. Professor Bravo Regidor, thank you for talking with us. I gather the agenda on the Mexican side and the U.S. side were alike in some ways, but different in some ways. What do you know about that?
In terms of the agenda, I think one of the most interesting aspects of this meeting is the fact that, on the one hand, President Obama was facing significant pressures to put human rights and security on the table, particularly the disappearance and probable killing of 43 students from the rural school of Ayotzinapa in the state of Guerrero. And President Peña Nieto, he was interested in talking about other things, about the border, about, you know, tightening commercial relationships, even about Cuba, but really not very interested in talking about human rights and security. So I think we're going to see some very interesting phrasing of the subject, as a result of the meeting.
Do you think President Peña Nieto gets something from this meeting that he can take home?
Well, to be honest, I think that in terms of his domestic agenda, the most important thing that he will bring home is the photo op, so to speak. President Peña Nieto is facing a really hard time in Mexico due to, an alleged extrajudicial execution of 22 citizens in the town of Tlatlaya in the state of Mexico, the Ayotzinapa situation that I just mentioned, and also the conflict of interest regarding his dealings, his wife and his Minister of Finance, regarding their dealings with a government contractor who built and financed their private homes. So in the context of that, of those scandals and of that crisis, I think it's good for President Peña Nieto, or I think he expects for his image with President Obama to give him some sort of boost, because, well, his popularity right now is really, really low.
Why is it, has it been so hard for him, do you think, to have a successful presidency? Why is he having these difficulties? And do you see a prospect that he has to make things better for himself? What are his, what are expectations right now for him?
Well, he's having a very hard time because he arrived to the presidency with very high expectations. There was an expectation that he was going to be an effective leader, a leader who produced results. And in the first months, even the first year, year and a half of his presidential term, President Peña Nieto really lived up to those expectations. He was able to push through Congress a very ambitious agenda of reforms in education, telecommunications, a fiscal reform, an energy reform, which really put the expectations even higher. But for the last 6 months, the implementation of some of these reforms has stagnated or has faced some difficulties in terms of the regulations or of the federal system that Mexico has and the distribution of competences between different levels of government. On the other hand, economic performance has been very mediocre, which is his structural problem of Mexico's for the last at least three decades. And on the other hand, President Peña Nieto very deliberately tried to take violence and insecurity off his presidential discourse and his presidential agenda. And, well, the Ayotzinapa situation, alongside with problems that have arisen in the state of Michoacán, has forced him to bring back the agenda of violence and insecurity and human rights violations. So all of these issues have combined to produce a sort of a perfect storm for President Peña Nieto.
Professor Carlos Bravo Regidor, we thank you.
Thank you for having me.